in and of itself is obviously a normal part of a human diet.
We know that we need fat in order to make hormones. Every cell in our body is made from fat. We need the fat for proper hormone production. We also want our body to make use of those fats to break them down as that fuel source in order to create ketone bodies. We want to provide that fat as a source of fuel for the brain. So it's very important to make sure that we get our fats in, especially if we want to maintain hormonal balance while we transition to keto.
There are essential fatty acids, meaning that we cannot make these fatty acids that our body requires to function, and we have to consume them exogenously. So we have to have fat in our diet.
Really, keto carb could actually fit into that. It's called a fat fast. Like if you break an overnight fast by eating fat, fat only, it is sometimes called a fat fast because it continues the fast and it actually helps increase ketone levels further a little faster. So it's really a great product.
If you pair a high fat diet with also a high carbohydrate diet, and specifically high in simple sugars and simple carbohydrates, that's what we call the Western diet. And in that context, yeah, a high fat, high sugar, high carb diet is bad for your health. High fat, very low carbohydrate diet that is properly formulated, meaning made up of good fats and whole real foods. Many studies have shown that there are many health benefits associated with this. It's all a little bit complicated, and not everyone responds to diets in the same way. So people who are kind of changing up their diet really need to keep an eye on what's happening in their body, doing regular blood work with your physician and making sure that things aren't going wonky, because we're all very unique, metabolically speaking. But there's certainly a lot of research right now going on with high fat, low carb ketogenic diets showing some really exciting, promising effects. So inherently fat is not a dangerous thing.